Alhamdulillah.
نعوذ به سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهد الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. عباد الله، أنصحكم ونفسي العاثمة بتقوى الله، أحثكم وإياها على طاعته، أحذركم وإياها وبال مخالفته جل وعلا ومعصيته. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا ونبينا وعظيمنا وشفيعنا ونور قلوبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي الأمين وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين، وارض اللهم عن أصحابه الغر الميامين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. أما بعد، يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في المحكم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وإني لغفار لمن تاب وآمن وعمل صالحا ثم اهتدى. الآية الكريمة we talked about it last week. Today we talked about last week in a very general way. I'm going to try to sort of dig in the ayah بإذن الله تعالى as much as we can to extract some of those gems from the book of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Those gems that need a diver. Now, يقول الله تعالى وإني لغفار. We talked about غفار being صيغة مبالغة, as the Arabs would say. يعني linguistically speaking, a form of exaggeration of exaggeration. Exaggeration of مغفرة, and the exaggeration of that exaggeration is غفار. جيد. If Allah says وإني لغفار, I am forgiving, what does that really entail? The مغفرة of Allah, we can look at it from two perspectives. The first perspective is to alleviate hopelessness. Why? Because Al-Islam is a deen of hope. Al-Islam is a deen of amal, hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنه لا ييأس من روح الله إلا القوم الكافرون. Allah declares it extremely explicit in the Quran when he says, which means those who are hopeless in Allah are those who are kuffar in Allah. إلا القوم الكافرون, except those who have kufr in Allah are those who are hopeless in Allah. What does that mean? It means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to always knock His door in that metaphorical sense. Now, in the sense that He wants you to go to Him and not lose hope in Him regardless. Regardless. Two ways. Number one, because hope, losing hope in Allah leads to disasters on the human relation. Now there's two ways. A relation of the creation with the creation and the relation of the creation with the Creator. If you lose hope in Allah and the door of forgiving and maghfirah is not open, it leads to disasters. Hadith Rawah Muslim. The Imam Muslim narrates Hadith and Yawad al-Hadith. من حديث سيدنا أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه يقول أبو سعيد قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله كان في من قبلكم before you in the nations before you a man killer that he was hitman now he is terminology يعني he was he killed for a living for enjoyment like some people nowadays do or for greed like some people nowadays do.
Or for narrow-mindedness, like most humans nowadays do.
Whatever.
That classification of their narrow-mindedness that gives them supposedly license to shed the blood of their fellow human being. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described to us in the Quran al-Kareem. The answer of the malaika when قال الله إني جاعل في الأرض خليفة, I am going to leave a khalifa on earth, I'm going to appoint a khalifa on earth.
قال وتجعل فيها ما يفسد فيها
ويسفك الدماء. Look at the detailed and precise answer of the malaika. قالوا, they said, oh Allah, you want to put a khalifa on earth, يعني human being, and you know these people will do two things. أتجعل فيها من يفسد فيها فساد. They will do corruption. Their behavior is corrupt. Their acts are corrupt. Their deeds are corrupt. Even nowadays, their intentions are corrupt. فساد, everything. In their dealings, there's فساد. Even in their ibadah that they do, there's فساد. They corrupt the ibadah even.
To serve the creation. No, they are supposed to serve the creator.
قال وتجعل فيها من يفسد فيها. But America did not stop here. ويسفك الدماء.
They shed blood. These people, these humans that you are leave there,
they shed blood of each other. As if they're not supposed to be doing that. The Quran is explicitly saying that.
مفهوم المخالفة. In the Quran there is that principle of مخالفة, which means the opposite of the meaning is also correct.
يسفك الدماء means shed blood. That human which is corrupt, it means the pious thing is not to shed blood. The righteous thing is not to shed blood. Anyway. This man, كان في من قبلكم, a man who killed 99 people. 99 souls. He killed them. One day, it happened to him. فسأل, الحديث says, فسأل عن أعلم أهل الأرض.
Look, I want you to pay attention to the verbatim or to the wording of the hadith here.
The hadith here, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us, he asked about the most knowledgeable people on earth. أعلم. أعلم from علم. The most knowledgeable.
Huh?
And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, فدل على رجل راهب.
Or فدل على راهب.
He was pointed towards a worshipper, zahid, abid,
not alim.
Lots of worship, lots of ibadah, lots of dhikr, lots of this, lots of salah, lots of siyam. Abid, rahib, yani the highest level of worship
based on minimum knowledge. Basic obligatory knowledge is fulfilled, minimum.
And the rest is ibadah, ta'ah.
Right. He went to him.
No, that's not what he asked for. He asked for a alim. فسأل عن أعلم أهل الأرض. He asked on the most knowledgeable on earth. But people directed him, this is a big man. Anyway. So he went. فقال, told him, look, I killed 99 people. Is there any way for me? I want to repent. مغفرة توبة. I want to go back to Allah. Is there a way for me?
راهب. Always in ibadah,
and if he does a blink of an eye in the wrong way, he considers himself lost. Now,
سيئات الأبرار,
عفوا حسنات الأبرار سيئات المقربين,
as you all know.
يعني المقربين, those who are close to Allah, the أولياء who are close to Allah, versus the أبرار, the general level of the أولياء.
أبرار are good. Pious people.
Those are general level of the awliya. But the muqarrabin are those who are close to Allah of the awliya. Notice what Ibn Athala and others mentioned, that the sayyi'at of the abrar, the bad deeds of what the muqarrabin, are good deeds to the abrar.
Yani abrar do good deeds thinking it's good deeds,
while the muqarrabin, the close awliya to Allah, view these deeds as bad deeds.
حسنات الأبرار سيئات المقربين.
There are hasanat to the abrar, but to the muqarrabin to Allah, there are sayyat.
Very nice. هذا الزاهد, this زاهد, this not زاهد. There are two kinds of زاهد. There is زاهد
in the dunya, يعني في الدنيا وعن الدنيا.
زاهد يعني someone is زاهد in everything else other than the dunya. And someone is زاهد in the dunya for the akhirah. Don't confuse زاهد. Because زاهد
means detached from. Some people are detached from the akhirah, attached to dunya.
So that's also زاهد. زاهد في الاخره. And there's a زاهد
in the dunya for the sake of the akhirah.
So it could be both ways. So may Allah save us from the زاهد, who is زاهد in the akhirah, but one in the dunya.
Anyway.
And Azad told him, you killed 99 people, there's no way for you. You're gone. Over. This murderer, when he heard that, he killed him. There's no way for you, so here you go. You're number 10, 100.
فَكَمَّلَ بِهِ مِيَا. So now he killed 100 people.
There's no way, why do I have, you know,
since there is no way for me to repent, there is no way for me to reform, the door of maghfirah is closed, so I might as well just kill you.
Go and kill him.
He went sometime, فَسَأَلَ عَنْ أَعْلَمِ أَهْلِ الْأَرْضِ. Then he asked about the most knowledgeable on earth. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, فَدُلَّ عَلَى رَجُلٍ عَالِمٍ. He was pointed to a alim. Alim from alam. World. Not like nowadays, because the reason I say that, I emphasize that, is because that world, this word alim, becomes a misnomer now. Misquoted and misrepresented. I mean, anyone who studies 5, 6, 7 books, one of the books studies 5, 6 years, they call him alim.
Well, alim what? One doesn't know anything yet. This is the beginning. Many of the ulama after the Azhar before the 50s,
there used to be no bachelor's, master's, or PhD degree. There used to be a one degree called al-alimiyya. Al-alimiyya.
Alim. Which people used to study for decades. Anyway, that's before Al-Azhar passed away and religion has on the Azhar.
Like before,
nowadays even more.
That's one example. Nowadays you have these courses where they give people, they say 5 and 6 and 7 and 8 years, and then they call themselves, they have no shame to call themselves alim after all this.
Up 6, 7 years now.
One of the shuyukhs, Sayyid Hawa rahmatullahi alayh, who went studied with Sheikh Muhammad Hamid, among the Hanafi scholars of Syria, he told him that, how dare you call yourself a alim and you have not studied the Hanafi fiqh for 30 years?
Faqih, you want to call yourself faqih like this.
But anyway, now with this express mode, like now we eat express meals, and we send express mail, and everything is express, also scholarship became express.
Part of the pattern.
La, this one is alim, literally. Alim, innama yakhsha Allah min ibadihi al-ulama. Those who have fear of Allah, khashya. And khashya is much more than fear. Anyway, are the ulama, as Allah says. Therefore, had al-alim, when this man, when this murderer came to him, he said to him, look, I have killed 100 people.
And this is, you know, this is what happened.
Hal li min tawba? Is there a way for me? Will Allah accept me? Can I repent? Is there a door for me open?
قال ومن يحول بينه وبينه. He told him, who would stand between you and Tawbah?
Who would stand between you and Allah?
Then this alim told him, look.
قال فذهب إلى أرض كذا وكذا. And
Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is telling us in hadith
that this man, this knowledgeable man, told him, go to this spot of the world, or this area of the world, or this village, or this place. اذهب إلى أرض كذا وكذا فإن بها أناسا يعبدون الله. For in that place there is a group of people.
Group of people, huh? Not many.
Group of people يعبدون الله. They worship Allah there. Go and join them. He says, واترك أرضك فإنها أرض سوء. And leave where you are, for it is a bad place.
I want to stop here for just a minute.
He told him, there's no reason for you, there's no barrier between you and Tawbah. Lakin, you have to abandon the place that you're in. The environment that you are in for this environment is the environment of evil.
I You have to look at your environment. Environment means what? Not only the geography, but it means the people. It means the anything that you're dealing with. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He talks about the wives, and He talks about the children, He talks about all these things and the money, not in the sense of hating or disliking or distancing. No, no, no. Because sometimes the people around you may point you to the wrong direction where you're supposed to be giving and contributing positively, you turn to contribute negatively. That's the wrong message. And therefore you have to see the environment. Leave the environment that's contaminated with evil and move to the environment where there is a group of people worshipping Allah. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, did not only say, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullah. Not enough. Ya alladhina amanu taqullah, not enough. Ya taqullah wa kunu ma'a as-salihin. Have taqwa of Allah, and taqwa is not only fear, by the way. Huh? Some other time. Have taqwa of Allah wa kunu. Be around as-salihin. Be around the pious people. Be around the knowledgeable people. Be around those who would lead you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be around them, accompany them, always remain with them. That's the whole point. That's the whole point. Well, didn't the Arabi rahimahullah, didn't he mention this in his, and when he says, long some other time we'll talk about it again. Among he says صدورها قوما رضوا بيسير من ملابسهم والقوت لا تخطر الدنيا بهاجسهم صدورها خاليات من وساوسهم فاصحبهم وتأدب في مجالسهم وخلي حظك مهما قدره الله. People whose hearts are cured or are working on their hearts, they're working on themselves, they are pleased with anything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them, they don't demand. Those, he says, فَصْحَبْهُمُ, accompany, be around them. But he says, تَأَدَّبْ, have adab in their majalis. With them, have adab, have etiquette, observe your heart. وَخَلِّ حَظَّكَ مَهْمَا قَدَّمُكَ وَرَا, and leave. No matter how much they put you to the front, remain at the back. Don't give yourself that ego that you think belongs to you. Remain always back. And he said, among the things also, it's a long thing, but he said also, فَصْحَبْهُمْ مُؤْرُ. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad. It escaped me now the name. لكن the first part, لكن the second part he says, وَعْلَمْ بِأَنَّ الرِّضَى يَخْتَصُّ مَنْ حَضَرَ. He says, remain with them and remember that the pleasure of Allah is poured upon those who are around them. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ only لا وَكُونُوا مَعَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Therefore he told them to move from this place to another place. You have to change your situation. If you are in a situation that's not conducive to worshipping Allah, not conducive to piety, not conducive to you producing and giving and contributing positively to yourself and your society and your community and the world as a whole, then you have to change. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Allah mentions, which means Allah does not change people until they change what's in themselves. You have to initiate the change in order for you to seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in order for you to go on the path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For people claim, everyone claims they are on the path to Allah. But then, how do you verify the reality from the delusion? Tasawwuf from tasawwur. From delusion. It's a big difference. So this man anyway, the hadith goes to say this, so you know at the end of the hadith, حَتَّى نَصَفَ الطَّرِيقِ فَانْطَلَقْ. This man, this killer, after that, that alim told him to go to another place, he actually did it. Notice, he did. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. He repented and he took his bags, went from the bad place and the environment he's in
towards the other place where the scholar told him to go. حتى إذا نصف الطريق. The hadith says until he came to the middle of the road between his old place and the place he's seeking to, he died.
فاختصمت فيه ملائكة الرحمة وملائكون الحديث.
What are the malaika now? They said, what we do, etc., etc.
Eventually, the man goes to Jannah, inshallah ta'ala.
That's to show you, so number one, وَإِنِّي لَغَفَارٌ. Let's go back to the hadith, to the ayah. وَإِنِّي لَغَفَارٌ. Because if Allah does not open that maghfirah, that gate of maghfirah and forgiveness for the human beings, that may lead to social disasters in the world. People go kill people. People do crazy things. People don't think that Allah is watching them. People, they go because there is no recording
in front of their eyes, though there is.
مَا يَنْفِرُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ.
Anything you say is written.
Like, because they don't see the front of their eyes, right in front of them, they think they go unaccounted for.
Nah, wait a minute.
That is the first thing. The second aspect we take from وَإِنِّي لَغَفَّارٌ is that Allah wants you to go to Him. Allah wants you to go to Him. Therefore, hadith is صحيح Imam Muslim, where النبي الأعظم صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وهو رسول الله خير خلق الله, the best of the creation صلى الله عليه وسلم, سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين الذي غفر له صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was forgiven anything and everything, not that he had anything, but that's a higher maqam صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله. You see that Imam Muslim hadith is صحيح that the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم makes istighfar 70 times every day of majlis. In one majlis, in one sitting, 70 times, Allahumma qfirli wa tub alay. Or even 100 times, two narrations are found in Sahih. Two authentic narrations. 70 times, wa huwa Rasulullah is saying, Allahumma qfirli wa tub alay. And sometimes, or other narrations, 100 times. That's what people could hear or could observe. Because you know that the Anbiya, even when they sleep, when their eyes sleep, their hearts don't sleep. That is sahih. So this is the brother of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to show us this way of maghfirah. And notice Nuh alayhi salam. Tara, the situation of Nuh alayhi salam was no different than our situation nowadays. Yani, when Nuh alayhi salam, the people were having economic hardship. Economy went down, plunged.
But nowadays, huh? Everything is going down.
People lost their homes, and people lost their jobs. People didn't have anything to eat. People didn't even have children. Somehow, something, whatever they did, maybe they ruined the environment at that time. Maybe the spiritual environment. Allah knows best. Whatever it is, the environment so that interfered with the fertility rate and the people of Nuh. Not only that, even now rain doesn't come anymore. Water doesn't come. Water is life. وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ. From water we made every living thing, Allah tells us, which means, so even water was deprived. Nuh alayhi salam only told them, فَقُلْتُ يَا قَوْمِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ. All I'm trying to tell you is do istighfar. This maghfirah here, you say all kinds of things. لَكِنْ istighfar. فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ. If you do istighfar, إِنَّهُ كَانَ
غَفَّارًا. What is غَفَّار?
وَإِنِّي لَغَفَّارٌ. فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا. Excessive maghfirah, excessive forgiving.
He's telling them the same thing.
يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا. First of all, you want rain. So your agriculture, your farms, your land. If you want your economy to change, if you are in an economical hardship, if you owe debts, if you are indebted to people, to banks, to corporations, to this, if you're looking for a way out, Nuh tells you, Al-Qur'an al-Kareem is yelling at all of us, استغفر ربكم. إنه كان غفارا. Number one, He will forgive your sins. Number two, يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدَرَارًا. He will open up the heavens and they will pour on you. Will pour on you with everything that's good. Not only that, وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ. And He will send you
that you are most. Money and children, man and baneen. money and children, that's what you want.
He will give you that. لكن استغفروا ربكم. إنه كان غفارا. First you do استغفار with real استغفار. Persistent استغفار. يرسل السماء عليكم. He will change your economy. The whole situation changes. And he will, that will even, that استغفار will interfere in the fertility rates.
وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ. You will have no offspring.
Pious offspring.
وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا.
He will give you fertile lands, he will give you rivers, he will give you all these things.
قُلْ قَوْلِ هَذَا الْسَّمْدِ. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إرغاما لمن جحد به وكفر أشهد أن سيدنا محمدا صلى الله عليه وعلى آله شفيع مشفع في المحشر صلى اللهم عليه وعلى آله أهل الفقه والنظر والعلم والأثر واعلم بآثارهم كفى وتبع.
Allah سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن many times talks about استغفار. He wants us to do استغفار. Very, very important, not only for to repair the relation between you and the creation, but to repair the relation between you and Him, and also to change the environment around you. Geology will change, rivers will come to you your way, farmland, agriculture, all that, economy will change, all these things, all these departments will have different functions all of a sudden. Why?
Because even epidemiology and statistics will change because of the infertility rates.
Change? Why? Because of istighfar.
Al-Asma'i, and I'll finish with this. Al-Asma'i was adib. Rawi al-Arab, they call him. يعني one of the sha'irs in the Abbasi time. He was very cunning, maker in the Makkah. Al-Asma'i. Anyway, Harun, Khalifa al-Abbasi, they call him al-Rashid. They used to call him Shaytan al-Shi'r. He is the Satan of Shi'r. He's very, very... Very eloquent in Shia. And one time among the things that, I'll say that real quick, one of the things that sometimes he used to do, Abu Ja'far, Khalifa al-Abbasi also, they call him al-Mansur, some people term him. He was also very stingy, Abu Ja'far, very stingy. The Abbasi Khalifas used to give people money, the Sha'irs money, if they come with a brand new Qasida. Anybody who comes with brand new Qasida, brand new poetry, nobody knows about it, they would give him lots of money. Based on where he wrote that qasida, يعني he wrote it in the old days, they would write it on what? On clay or on wood or whatever it is. So they would bring that that clay and he would give him the money. And Abu Ja'far, he made a trick. The trick was that he used to have a very good memory. If he hears something one time, he memorizes it. Abu Ja'far, Khalifa himself. He also had two servants, one male and one female. The male servant, if he hears it twice, he memorizes it entirely. The female servant, if he hears it three, she hears it three times, she memorizes it. So what he started doing is, any sha'ir that comes to him and gives him a qasida, he enjoys the qasida. After the sha'ir is finished, he says, oh, I know this already. He says, oh, no. He says, okay, listen to it. He says it all to the Bible. So not only me, I know it, also my servant knows it. Says it, kill him. He already heard it once, he says it. So not only him, he knows it, also the other maid, she knows it. Tell him the qasida, she recites all. The sha'ir goes, after all this hardship, no money. And Asma'i told him, he said, this is, you know, this is what he's doing. And we know there's no way that anybody could have said this, these words. So he went and did a qasida that is very complicated and very repetitive and has many different meanings and difficult words. It's very hard to memorize. Huh? And he went to him. He went to, he changed the way he looked, and he went to who? To Abu Ja'far. He says, I have a new qasida. He says, you know, if nobody says it, nobody knows it, you'll get the money. He says it. He may say, سمعت صوت البلبل هيج قلبي الثاني لي الماء وسأر معا مع زهر لحظ المقلي وأنت يا سيد لي وسيدي ومولى لي. He starts going like this, huh? And really, very repetitive. And very, أطفته من وجنة بينزق من لفني ورد الخجلي فقال لا 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 وقد غدا مهرولي فوالولاد وولولاد ولي ولي يا ويلي فقلت لا تولولي وبيني لؤلؤي
very repetitive and very difficult to memorize.
So he said that I don't know.
So he says, where did you write this qasida? Give us, so we'll pay you. He says, I wrote it on the wall of my house.
Well, you have to weigh the wall and give them gold equal to the wall, that's a big thing.
So they figured out, they said, this must be the Asma'i. Open your face, it turns out the Asma'i. Anyway, that Asma'i, he says, one time, and we'll finish, he says, one time I was doing tawaf around the Kaaba. And I saw a young man holding to the ropes of the Kaaba and crying, and he's saying this, Ya man yujibu du'a al-muttarri fi al-ghulami. Oh, you Allah, who answers to those who are in need in the darkness of the night. Ya kashif al-durri wal-balwa ma'an niqami. You who remove everything from the slaves who seek you or beseech you. In qad da'awtuka hazeenan ha'iman qaliqan fakshif bimabi. Or fakham bukai bihaqti al-bayti wal-harami. He says, I am calling upon you, I am invoking your name, sad and worried. And I have no one but you, so give mercy to me because of this haram and this house and the place I'm in. إِنْ كَانَ عَفْوُكَ لَا يَرْجُوهُ ذُو سَفَهِمْ. If your forgiveness is not given to those who make mistakes, فَمَنْ يَجُودُ عَلَى الْعَصِينَ بِالْكَرَمِ. Who will give, who will be generous on those who sin? قَدْ نَامَ وَفْدُكَ حَوْلَ الْبَيْتِ وَارْتَحَلُوا أَوْ انْتَبَهُوا وَأَنْتَ وَحْدَكَ يَا قَيُّومُ لَنْ تَنَمِي. Everyone went to sleep, says oh Allah, but you are the one who was not subject to sleep. And Asma'i said, I came to him and I realized he was Zayn al-Abidin, Ali ibn al-Husayn. I said, Sayyidi, ma li hadha al-jaza' wal-buka? Why, how come you cry so much and you say, God, you scared me if someone like you from the household of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi says something like this, what about me? Huh? He says, who is this? Then Abdiyaz, he says, Ubayy ibn al-Asma'i. He says, you're a little slave of al-Asma'i. He says, hayhata, hayhata, ya Asma'i. Zain al-Abidin. He says, Asma'i, be careful. Allah, in Allah, khalaqanna. Allah created al-Jannah for whoever obeys him, even if he is a Abid Habashi. And he created Jahannam for those who disobey him, even if he was a Sayyid Qurashi.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. كما صليت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين أعلي مولانا كلمة الحق والدين اللهم من أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين خيرا فوفقه إليه من أراد بهم غير ذلك فاجعل دائرة السوء عليه اللهم رد المسلمين إلى دينك ردا جميلا آت أنفسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها اشف اللهم مرضانا وعاف مبتلانا وفك أسرانا وارحم موتانا كن لهم لنا ولمشايخنا ولوالدينا ولمن له حق علينا ولمن على الخير أعاننا وعن الشر أبعدنا ولمن أوصانا بالدعاء وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله أقم الصلاة
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر